around the world with MS World. I'm Dr. Daniel Cantor here with MS World at the Consortium of MS Center annual meeting. One of the great things about the Consortium of MS Centers is really the multidisciplinary nature of it. We get not just neurologists, not just physiatrists, also called physiatrists or physical medicine rehabilitation doctors. We get physical therapists, occupational therapists, speech therapists, social workers, case managers, pharmacists. The list just goes on, and nurses and nurse practitioners and PAs. Exactly. And it just goes on and on and on. So I'm so happy to be joined here by Bryan Hutchinson, who's the director of an MS Achievement Center in Greater Sacramento. And what I want to know is, what's an MS Achievement Center?
Well, MS Achievement Centers can take a lot of different forms. The form that we've taken is as a day wellness program. So what that means is people come for a day as a day program, like an adult daycare center, and they participate in physical, cognitive, and emotional wellness activities. So what does that mean? The physical activities can include individualized fitness. So we have individualized exercise programs for the people with multiple sclerosis. We have Pilates. We're going to incorporate some yoga. We want to do some other types of activities like that. Cognitive stimulation tends to be in a more of a smaller group. At least the formal aspects tend to be in more of a small group. So they go through different cognitive activities and are provided different strategies on ways in which they can improve their cognition. So pacing and being able to use memory aids, those kinds of things, whether it be technology or otherwise. And then we have some fun thrown in. So we do some recreational activities, which can include physical types of activities like bocce ball, ladder golf. We use the Wii and all of these things where people are having fun but actually getting some therapeutic benefit. We also incorporate cognitive activities like cribbage and Yahtzee and card games and those kinds of things. So the goal really is to form a community, get people to really start thinking around wellness concepts, but also being able to support each other.
And that's an important concept, really, this idea that we go see doctors when we're sick, but really it should be more about wellness and about well visits and about what we can do about that. A big issue that's come up, especially this year, especially in 2014, has been access to care. So a lot of people watching this video probably say, well, I can't even get my insurance to pay for basic things. For most people, how do they pay for the Achievement Center?
The Achievement Center, thankfully, was underwritten by a very nice grant from the Conrad N. Hilton Foundation, at least our Achievement Center. So the majority of our operating costs currently are underwritten. The remainder of what is not underwritten by that grant is underwritten by Dignity Health Neurological Institute, which is a hospital system within the state of California, as well as Arizona. We do have a fee, a sliding fee scale, or sliding scale fee for our program. So that ranges anywhere from $20 a month to $300 a month. So it's still very affordable, but what it also does is it provides investment into the program.
This sounds like a great way of really a partnership between a philanthropy, right? So the Conrad Hilton Foundation, but then also you said with Dignity Health and with the neurological, so you really have hospitals and doctors and everyone trying to make the community healthier.
Right.
If you're interested, if there's an MS Achievement Center in your area, one way of finding out is actually to go and visit the Consortium of MS Centers website. So if you go to mscare.org, it will give you more information if there's an MS Center in your area, and it might even say that you're one of the lucky to have an MS Achievement Center. Right. I want to thank you so much
Thanks.
For joining us.
Thank you.